Hello and welcome to our today's how-to video about the advanced car settings in the Fronius Wattpilot. In this video, we are going to show you on how to use the advanced car settings to make sure that your electric vehicle is being charged at a good pace. Please note, this video is being captured with the software version 1.5.0, and whenever you're doing settings on your Wattpilot that you can't reset, you can just do your RFID reset card and reset the Wattpilot to factory settings. So whenever you have troubles with the settings, just use the factory reset to redo these factory settings. Yeah, so now let's have a look into the Fronius Solar Wattpilot app. And of course, you need to have the app to set the car settings in the app itself. So first of all, we have here the start screen of the app, and down below you can see the point settings. When you now click to settings, you can see in this register smart settings, you can see the point cost optimization. And when you click on cost optimization, you can scroll to the bottom of the page, and there you will find the advanced settings of your car. You can click onto car and then enter the settings for the advanced car settings. First of all, why do we need the advanced car settings? Most of the cars out there on the market, they support the PV optimized charging process. However, depending on the electric vehicle and depending on the onboard charger and the used firmware of the electric vehicle, unfortunately, not all the car models out there on the market, they support PV surplus optimized charging. So depending on the car model and depending on the manufacturer, it can be that your car is not supporting the PV optimized charging process. Unfortunately, for now, there is no standard on the market for the PV optimized charging process. So therefore, every car manufacturer is doing the onboard charger different. And therefore, it can be that you experience troubles during the charging process of your electric vehicle with the PV surplus optimization. Therefore, we have come up with a solution to enable you to charge your electric vehicle, although the car is not supporting the PV surplus optimized charging process. Yeah, therefore we have, first of all, in this list, the so-called standard charging behavior. Fortunately, most of the cars out there on the market, they support the PV optimized charging process. So whenever you have a standard car, just go with the factory setting of the standard charging behavior and you will experience no troubles with the charging and the charging process will take on normally. However, as you can see, we have a list of cars that don't support this PV surplus optimized charging process. So therefore, if you find your electric vehicle in that list, please make sure to choose the electric vehicle from the list to make sure that the Wattpilot can charge your electric vehicle in a PV optimized way. So whenever you are choosing one of these cars, the Wattpilot will then configure it to the settings that are needed for this specific electric vehicle. As you can see, this list is growing from software version to software version. This is since we are testing out most of the cars here at Fronius to make sure that we deliver you the best experience with charging with your PV system. So therefore, this list is already growing, and when we have new cars that are not optimized for PV surplus charging, we will try to take them onto the list and try to find presets, the so-called presets for these vehicles, to make sure that they are compatible with the PV surplus charging. So when you have a car and an unfortunate event happens and you don't have the possibility to charge with the PV surplus energy and your car has troubles, for example, and interrupts the charging process or doesn't charge the charging process, or if you have other troubles with the electric vehicle, then we have given you the opportunity to take the presets yourself. And the settings that you can find under the list, these settings can be done by yourself to optimize your electric vehicle if it is not implemented in the list yet, or if you have other troubles with the charging process. So therefore, we give you the opportunity to take the settings yourself and experiment with your electric vehicle to make sure that it is being charged with PV surplus energy. However, if you have experienced any troubles with your electric vehicle, please give us feedback so that we can test out these cars if you are using a car that we haven't taken up now. Yeah, so let's go through these advanced settings that you can take here. First of all, we have the minimum current. And it can be that your electric vehicle needs a higher current than 6 amps to start the charging process. A very prominent example here is, for example, the Renault Zoe. And this car needs at least 10 amps to start the charging process correctly. Therefore, as you can see, when you're choosing the Renault Zoe from the list, the Wattpilot will automatically configure it to a minimum charging current of 10 amps to enable the charging process with this specific car. Yeah, you can set this minimum current to whatever value you want and can experiment with that settings then yourself. Yeah, the second point is then the forced charging interval. And this can be that your electric vehicle doesn't charge the charging process after a specific time when there was an interruption. So for example, when there is clouds over your PV system, the Wattpilot will stop or pause the charging process to make sure that it is only being charged with PV surplus energy. Yeah, and if your vehicle doesn't support that, you can, for example, set the forced charging interval of, for example, 20 minutes. And this will make sure that the Wattpilot will start your charging process each and every 20 minutes to avoid that your car is going into deep sleep and doesn't start the charging process after a while, for example. Please make sure, however, when you are charging overnight, of course, this will mean with a forced charging interval that your car is repeatedly awaken and of course starts the charging process so that there are no troubles within. Therefore, this value is currently and factory set it to zero. Yeah, second thing is then allow charge pause. And this allow charge pause is a very vital functionality for the PV optimized charging. So therefore, with these charge pauses, we have the possibility to interrupt the charging process when there is, for example, too low PV irradiation to keep the charging process alive. This would mean that whenever, for example, there is a cloud over the PV system and there is not enough PV surplus energy, that the Wattpilot will stop the charging process and will wait until the PV surplus energy comes back again. When that happens, then the Wattpilot will start the charging process again. However, unfortunately, there are some cars out there on the market that don't support that. So therefore, when you stop the charging process, they will go to deep sleep and therefore will not re-enter the charging process anymore, and therefore the charging process is stopped. And of course, you want to avoid that, and therefore you can deactivate allow charge pause and therefore make sure that your electric vehicle is being charged at the continuous way. However, especially when charging with PV surplus energy, of course, this can be troublesome because when you're going overnight, for example, that would mean that your electric vehicle is being charged the whole night, even if there is no PV surplus energy. So please be very careful when deactivating the allow charge pause button. Yeah, then the next step, this is simulate unplug. And in this case, with the Wattpilot, this is a very specific functionality. And with this simulate unplugging process, you can simulate the electric vehicle that the type 2 connector is being plugged out and plugged into the electric vehicle again. So for the car, this would mean that the same process happens as if you would go to the car, unplug it and plug it in again. For most of the cars, this renews the charging process and enables us to start the charging process again. So this functionality is very good for the functionality of the PV surplus charging and of course even for the zero to three phase switchover, this would mean that we can simulate this unplugging process. However, some cars doesn't support that or some cars doesn't need that, so therefore you can activate or deactivate the simulate unplugging feature. Yeah, the next possibility is then the charging pause. And this can be that the interruption of the charging process can start the charging again. So for example, a charge pause of 5 minutes would mean that there is a time frame of 5 minutes until the charge interruption will start up again. This is vital for cars that need a charge pause between interruptions. So for example, when the charging process is being stopped by clouds on the PV system, then with this 5 minute setting, the Wattpilot will wait at least 5 minutes until the charging process starts again. Factory redone, this value is set to zero. So whenever there is PV surplus energy again, the Wattpilot will instantly start the charging process again. However, there are some cars that don't support that. So therefore you can set here a specific value that is good for your car. Yeah, and then the next value, this is the minimum charging time. And this is also being a good functionality to avoid troubles with the charging process, because that would mean that, for example, the minimum charging time of 10 minutes would mean that the charging process lasts at least 10 minutes, for example, after it started in the first place. So whenever there is PV surplus energy in the morning, for example, and the Wattpilot starts the charging process, with these 10 minute settings, this would mean that the Wattpilot charges 10 minutes at least, no matter if there is PV surplus energy or not. Of course, you can set this period to a longer time frame if your car needs that. Otherwise, you can set it, for example, to 5 minutes. Yeah, then the next option is the choose of the phase switching process. And you can set this between automatic, only single phase, and only three phase. And normally these settings are done on automatic, so that would mean that the Wattpilot can automatically switch between the single phase and the three phase switchover. So this would mean that the Wattpilot always fits your PV system and optimally uses the PV surplus energy and the whole power of the PV system. However, it can be that your electric vehicle, for example, is very inefficient on a single phase charging process. So therefore, you will have the opportunity to charge only on a three phase system. So this would mean better efficiency for your electric vehicle and better efficiency during the charging process. So whenever you know that your car is very inefficient in the single phase charging process, you can opt out for only three phase charging, or of course also for only one phase single phase charging. Yeah, please note, however, if you're switching here to only single phase or only three phase, then that would mean that the Wattpilot is only charging on a single phase or on a three phase all the time, so there is no switchover. If you want to implement the switchover, the automatic switchover feature, of course, this setting needs to be done on automatic switchover. Yeah, and with that comes, of course, also the three phase power level. And this power level is automatically set to 4.2 kilowatts of power. And this is due to the fact that the electric vehicles need a minimum charging current of 6 amps. And when you're charging at 6 amps on a three-phase system, this would mean a power of 4.2 kilowatts. And of course, the Wattpilot will then start the charging process whenever you have 4.2 kilowatts of PV surplus energy available. At that pace, the Wattpilot will switch over to the three-phase charging and start charging the vehicle with a three-phase, and therefore make sure that these 4.2 kilowatts are being used for the three-phase charging process of your vehicle. However, you can alternate this value. For example, if you know you have an electric vehicle, this is very efficient for the electric vehicle when you're charging on a three-phase, then you can, for example, set this value lower, let's say to 2 kilowatts, that your electric vehicle will start on a three-phase whenever there is 2 kilowatts of PV surplus energy. However, please note, if you lower down this value, this would mean that the electric vehicle is also drawing energy from the public grid. Or if you have a PV stationary battery system, also energy is being drawn from the stationary battery system. If you want to avoid this, you can set the value to the 4.2 kilowatts, and that would mean that the Wattpilot is switching to the three phase charging first when there is enough PV surplus energy from the PV system. Yeah, on the other hand side, you can also raise this value up to a higher value to avoid that the electric vehicle is being switched at 6 amps, but at a higher power level, for example. Yeah, then the last two options here, we have the phase switch delay. And this would mean that after a specific time, the phase switch happens. So for example, in this case, this is factory set to 2 minutes. So that would mean that after 2 minutes, the phase switch is enabled. So whenever you are charging on a three phase charging, for example, then it would take 2 minutes. And this would, so to say, permanently exceed the charging process. And this would be a time frame to avoid that the Wattpilot switches on a three phase system early, to avoid that there is not enough PV surplus energy, for example. So in this case, if you want to make sure that you have really enough power in the morning hours, for example, you can prolong this period, for example, set it to a phase switch delay of 10 minutes. And therefore, the Wattpilot will wait a little longer until it will switch to the three phase system to make sure that there is enough PV surplus energy coming down from your roof. Yeah, and then the last setting, this is the phase switch interval, and this would mean the time frame between single and three phase switchovers. Most of the cars, they don't like it when they are being switched on and off continuously. So especially in times when there is a middle power of PV irradiation, for example. And when you are exactly at the limit of the three-phase charging, this would mean that when there is a cloud, for example, the limit will drop below the three-phase limit, and then 2 minutes after that, it will rise up above again. So to avoid a switch over too often, you can set the phase switch interval. For example, it is factory set to 10 minutes, but you can also prolong that, for example, to 20 minutes. So that would mean that when you are on a specific phase level, that it will last at least at 20 minutes. So whenever the Wattpilot is switching to three phase charging, then it will stay there for, in this case, 20 minutes. And after the 20 minutes, then it can change back to the single phase charging, for example. However, if you prolong this period, please note that, of course, the Wattpilot is being charged on a three phase, for example, even if there is not enough PV surplus energy anymore. So that would mean that the energy is also being drawn from the public grid. Okay, after the settings of your car and of the Wattpilot, please hit also the save button on the right top corner to save the settings in your Wattpilot and therefore make sure that your electric vehicle is now being charged with the optimal settings to implement the PV surplus energy charging. Yeah, I hope this was informative for you and you can now set your Wattpilot to the perfect pre-settings to enable perfect PV surplus energy with your Wattpilot. So, until the next time, hope you had fun. See you the next time here at Fronius. Keep safe and keep charging. Bye bye.